seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban.
Oh, this chair is not that safe to lean back on. It felt like it was almost gonna break.
Oh, the hell? 10 seconds it's Owen's chair. Explains a lot.
There we go.
5 seconds remaining.
Well, yeah, let's see if we have more Centaur games.
Radiant team. Hope not.
Hello, welcome back to the European Regional Qualifiers for the Boston Major 2016. Alliance and the Imperial will be the teams playing for you right now. And I'm sitting here with Fogg, and we are in the draft. Hello, Fogg.
Hello.
How are you doing today?
I am doing okay. I'm kind of sad to see Escape lose that game like that before, but I'm sure they're sadder. They need those wins.
Yes.
EP is probably the only one that they can lose to, but them dropping games yesterday was not good. So they need to pick it up. They can't lose any more games.
They do. And for these two teams, this is their first game today. Alliance is 3-2 so far. They lost against Ad Finem, Escape Gaming, Team Liquid, and then they were able to win against Na'Vi and Fantastic Five. So they've kind of reached their max of teams they can lose to, so they need to win.
I don't remember them losing to Liquid. I remember them losing to themselves.
That was, yeah. I was like, wait a second, everybody saw that game. Oh, wait.
That was,
guys, if you haven't watched Liquid versus Alliance yesterday, there is a very boring mid game, but it will all be worth it in the end. You got to watch it. It is beautiful.
Yeah, the last 15 minutes are probably the most...
There's some amazing play in there, and there's some facepalm play in there.
Yes.
It is not yet at the level of Envy and Roshan, though.
No, it's close, though.
It is very close.
It's pretty close. But taking a look at these two teams, yep. Imperial gets their Ogre, their lovely Ogre, which have a 93% win rate. So yeah.
Imperial is 4-1, by the way, so they kind of already lost.
You mean 1-4, right?
Yes.
Imperial.
They lost four games, sorry. They lost against Ad Finem, Team Liquid, Team Secret, and Virtus Pro. To be honest, those are the four teams that I'm expecting to see in the top four.
Yeah, yeah. And I think this
and they
game,
won against Escape.
They're looking good with their first two picks, though. Ogre with the Bloodlust plus the Drow Ranger with the auras. We've been seeing this a lot. It's just super powerful, super potent, how much damage you deal out.
Mm-hmm.
The bans were a little weird. Alliance banning out the Bounty Hunter. That one was a little strange for me instead of banning the Ogre. But I guess they don't want to deal with a Bounty Hunter.
They don't. I do get the sniper ban. I like that a lot, but I would have also liked Baby Knight seeing sniper. Yes, I would like to see sniper. I said it out loud. Sue me.
Damn it, Shiver. How dare you?
Yeah. So the Imperial with the Ogre Magi Drow Ranger opening very strong. Which heroes do you like to see with that? I think actually both openings are fairly strong.
Yeah.
I like it. I think we have a good game on our hands as long as Centaur doesn't get picked.
Yes, as long as Centaur is not played on the one. You hear me, Ace?
Yeah.
Don't
I hope he's playing the Drow Ranger this time.
I think that they're going to change it up from yesterday. They had it, I think they lost all the Centaur games.
Yeah,
so
they did.
They picked it like three times as well, so they were just kind of banging their heads against the wall.
Yeah.
But now they got the... So they ban out the Bristle. That's a combo that Alliance has ran before, you know, when they were... Formerly with the Complexity Boys, with Limp and Hanskin, they were doing like the Coddle Bristle dual lane off lanes with Jonas as well from Nip, the Wisp Bristles and stuff, so... And it's an in-your-face hero for the Drow Rangers, so interesting two bans there from Imperial, the Bristle and the PA, while Alliance... Yeah, banning out Baby Knight's OD, which he's been playing a lot, even though he hasn't really been having the best success in the, best success in the major qualifiers with it, but still, they don't want to play versus it. It's an annoying hero for sure.
Okay, so Alliance has taken it to their bonus time. Maybe they, or maybe Imperial kind of did ban out the heroes that they were planning to go for.
Yeah, what are the heroes left for Alliance? They've got the Loaded Jug, which they've kind of been staying away from, but I think it's been banned a lot of the times. They've still got the Naga Siren if they want to do that with the Coddle. Which
they played the Gyro Cups yesterday as well.
They have been bringing back the Gyro.
Yeah.
They love their aggro tri-lanes as well, which was a solution that people were kind of looking at to the Drow Ranger for a bit. You just kind of pressure him a lot and you don't let him get his levels or his aura up.
Yeah, especially if you would have a Disruptor, but they go for a Rubik instead. So no hands can Disruptor.
Yep. But the EGM Rubik. Now he can steal Bloodlust. Mwahaha. No, it's just a hero that we've been seeing come back.
It's actually very simple to steal, yeah. That's great.
It's the only spell he's going to cast the whole game, pretty much, so.
Most likely.
Should be able to get it.
Okay, so. Ruby Keeper of Light supports. We got Jonas of Van on the Sand King, and then he leaves our lowdown Limp hero. Tiny is good with the Coddle. The Limp likes to play. You kind of want heroes that go up in the face of Drow Ranger, though, right? Maybe Tiny is one of those.
Yeah, Tiny's not too bad. And it's like Limp's best hero, so don't see why they would stray away from what they've been doing so well with. And then they need just a hard load to carry. Limp usually, I don't know, every time I see Limp play Tiny, he actually goes godlike pretty much every single time. Imperial.
The beast.
They've got the big hero that I'm thinking of is, I mean, Warlock. I'm actually surprised it wasn't grabbed up. It's got like one of the highest win rate and pick rates in the Boston qualifier so far, but it's not like the best with their heroes. It's okay though. It's just a strong hero in general.
Was it Baby Knight that played Warlock?
Yes.
Few days ago?
He played it. Wasn't it yesterday?
It was yesterday.
Yeah, he got the eggs, then it looked like he was going for a refresher. That was the Centaur game.
That was the Centaur game,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that was the Centaur game that we actually casted. So.
Well, a Warlock with Centaur there. Without a Centaur there, could still work.
Yeah.
Especially with the Drow Ranger ore.
Yeah, I don't know if they want to do a core Warlock again. I think they're kind of like switching things up from going for that like mid-game tempo stuff to just playing for the late game. It seems like that's what a lot of these teams are doing. And they go for the Oracle, which there's not really anything specific for this Oracle pick, it seems. There's nothing like, no big save, but...
Save from people that get lifted by Rubik? It's the only thing I can think of. Can you get rid of the Mana Leak?
You can purge the Mana Leak and you can Fate's Edict whenever the Sand King epis, so you can pretty much eat the whole epi without just the magic damage immunity. And he benefits a lot from the Drow Aura in the laning phase, because he attacks so quick, he has such a good base attack time.
Yeah, and his base damage is the one that got nerfed, but with the Drow Ranger that fixes that.
Yep. Alliance picking up this Timber. Which
a Limp Timber?
Yeah, probably. Yes. Yeah. Okay.
What do you make of that? Because I thought Drow Ranger was pretty good against that with the Gust.
Maybe they want to go for, I mean, it's Alliance, maybe they want to set up for some, like we were mentioning, the aggro dual tri-lane and put Jonas in a 1v1 matchup with the Timbersaw. Like forcing the pressure off him, because Timber does pretty well in most 1v1s as long as nobody else comes into his face. But Storm's a pretty good hero versus Timber in lane. And throughout most of the stages of the game, especially with the Drow Aura and Bloodlust. So, Imperial already changing it up, not going for that mid-game stuff. They're drafting a very... very hard scaling lineup with very little team fight so far, though. 10 seconds
remaining. Very little team fight.
Yeah. 5 seconds Alliance, however, remaining. Is already going for a single core lineup versus a Drow Ranger and a Storm Spirit with Bloodlust.
And Alliance is the one to remove the Legion Commander. And we're looking for a Hesta Joe hero, right?
Definitely, actually. And what I think of Alliance just banned LC, like that like sparks Naga into my head, but I don't even know how good Naga is versus like Storm Spear and stuff, but they do need a very hard carry. Alliance has a single core lineup right now. Right now they don't scale too well into the late game. BKB's hard counter all four of those heroes. But even Naga doesn't give you the physical aspect. Alliance just needs a physical damage dealer actually at this point.
Because for Imperial, they have a fairly fast lineup in terms of peak timings. Is Alliance's lineup enough to stop that, you think? Because wouldn't their core also need to be able to fight earlier on? Because it just feels otherwise that they're going to be run over and that Imperial should take the lanes, because the Drow Ranger just makes them win the lanes, and on top of that they got an Ogre Magi, which is a lane winner on itself. And then they should be able to win in the mid game before Alliance can even do anything at all.
And they scale super hard. Alliance has... they at least have, like, decent mid game. I think it's up to just how the lanes get matched up. Because if Alliance does do well in their aggro, so that's actually maybe also why Imperial went for the Oracle, so they can have strong lanes. The Ogre, Oracle, Drow, that's a pretty strong, you know, pretty lethal tri-lane. And Imperial now, yeah, they're going for hardcore. Like, this lineup scales pretty indefinitely. Void, Drow, Storm Spirit. And that gives them a bit of teamfight, which they were lacking. They don't really have any, I guess you could say, like, big spellcaster, big combo with the Void, but he's just a safe, strong hero.
Yeah. And at the same time, perhaps... Oh, no. I don't think Alliance would have gone for that anyway. Let's take a look at what Loda is going to play. We still have, in terms of heroes that he likes to play, we still have Slardar in the pool.
Don't think
still have
skills.
Juggernaut in the pool. Still have Morphling in the pool.
What solves their issues?
Gyrocopter in the pool. What solves their issues? That is the infinite question.
I don't know, actually. I think they, like... I don't know. I think that they're kind of, like, locked into their gyro already for going for, like, an aggro, but... They go for the...
You're right. They are going for
okay,
the
aggro. So they went for the Nog instead, but I actually... they need it because they... Like we said, they need a super hard carry, but I was kind of not liking it so much because... They... Like, look at their heroes. If anybody has a BKB... Like, of course, they're not going to go first item BKB on Drow or Storm Spirit, obviously, but once they hit, like, one or two items and then they get a BKB, Alliance's lineup is, like, full hard countered. And Naga Siren being able to split push is all dandy, but when there's a Storm Spirit who should be pretty farmed hunting you, that's the struggle. So this is going to be a little hard for Alliance. It's going to be really up to how well they do with their laning phase, how well... Which I'm assuming is going to be an aggro.
Yeah.
They're going to put the Sand King versus the Void.
Wouldn't Alchemist have done a better job for Alliance?
In the safe lane?
Maybe, yeah.
I think that they would have their work cut out for them in the laning phase. Because then there's like no one who really can... It's like, okay, Sand King, you're our playmaker. You got to do everything. That puts a lot of pressure on Jonas.
Okay.
This, I think that they're just like, okay, we have to get a hard carry. So they just, I feel like they were just like locked into getting one of these two, like the Naga. I mean, they like the gyro. I didn't really think it was too great, but we'll see how it ends up working out for them. I'm personally liking Imperials just because.
Oh, where's the predictions?
Super hard. Last guy needs a pick before you can make them.
Oh. Damn it. Okay. Well, while they are paused, then. Let's take a look who's playing what. Hanskin will play Rubik, Jonas will find Sand King, Limp will be on the Timbersaw, and EGM Coddle and the Loda Naga Siren. I don't think anything of that is a surprise. Looking towards Imperial, the Danes, Ryze on the Oracle. We have got Ace on the Drow Ranger, Hester Joe Rotten on the Faces Void, Noya on the Ogre Magi, and that will leave Baby Knight to play the Storm Spirit, but he hasn't picked it yet.
We are 5 minutes delayed, but just taking a look at what you guys are saying in chat, that would have been a pretty devastating Huskar pick if Imperial actually did it with the Oracle versus Alliance lineup, because like we mentioned, Alliance is pretty much all magical, so that would have been like an auto-win Huskar pick. Probably.
That would have been really good.
Yeah.
Instead of the Faces Void, could they have done it?
Maybe instead of the Storm, I don't know. Maybe probably instead of the Void. But either way, they've got a different idea, so we'll see how this decides to play out. And I'm still assuming that Alliance is going to go for the aggro pressure.
First Roshan kill.
Oh, Imperial all the way.
Player with the least deaths. Storm, Hester Joe, or Loda?
That one I'm not too sure about, actually.
Loda's not going to come in fights.
I'm not too sure, actually. That's a little hard to tell.
Let's do Hester Joe.
I'll do Hester Joe, sure. Why not?
Player with the most observer wards. Player who places the most observer wards by 15 minutes. Wait. Ryze?
Ryze or Noya, right? Yeah.
It would be Ryze. He's carrying the wards. Noya's not carrying anything. Let's do Ryze. Highest net worth by 25 minutes. Ace?
Yeah, I think Ace is a safe bet.
Okay.
Look, Loda might have highest net worth, but I don't know if it's going to... If
25
it's gonna be
minutes.
Them winning. Yeah, and that's 25. They may already be getting kind of crushed at that point. Yeah, sure.
Towers taken into account. We'll see. So far, both teams are not actually making a move in the jungle. They're just going to try to get the rune. And hopefully, they're both going to try to get the same rune, which looks to be the bottom rune. Maybe.
Yep, both teams got out and put an early ward down, too. So they both have a similar vision of the opposing jungles. Imperial gets one up on that high ground, and Alliance gets one on that middle where they get the scout. So it's pretty much the same ward, actually.
Yeah.
Just, yeah, different jungles.
Let's see if SCJO is gonna get this rune.
Yep, they're dodging. They're assuming the aggro Alliance tri lane, but I think Alliance now is gonna do normal. Jonas with the stun!
Jonas,
but now his stun's on cooldown, he's gonna take a good amount of damage. He should be just fine though, shouldn't die.
Draw Ranger aura, it's not there yet. Needs it! That's
and now
a shame.
They re-switch the lanes again. As soon as they saw the sanking bottom, they're like, alright, let's move the draw back down here and throw the void to the sack lane.
Yeah, he's making his way over. Okay, that will make us have a Storm Spirit versus Timber Saw lane mid, and you already mentioned that that is a pretty okay lane for Baby Knight Storm Spirit.
Yeah, it's not that bad for the Timber once he gets a couple levels of the armor, but with the Drow aura, it just makes it a little bit Storm favored, I'd say. Because the Storm can always just like spam and push the waves into the Timber, but Timber is such a hard hero like to actually just dominate in the lane. There's very few heroes that do it.
So in terms of this bottom lane, we got a Sand King with a Caudle on the Alliance's side, and Imperial has got this tri lane. What do you feel this would happen here?
They're trying to at least cause some pressure from Alliance, but I don't really feel like them having EGM down here for too long is gonna do too much. But he's gonna at least blast the camp, get a CS. Be a little bit annoying, but as long as Imperial's smart about their pulls and spreading out their levels, it'll be good.
They swap lanes.
Right away swap. Okay.
Naga Siren went to bottom lane. Sanky went to top lane. Naga has the Caudle, of course, still there. And it is the Rubik that is teleporting bottom to complete the aggressive tri lane.
Okay. All right.
Musical lanes. Who's the first one to give up moving is the question. Because if you see that, wouldn't Imperial just move away?
They've already almost got level 3 on the Drow Ranger. So they've got to have level 2 aura. And I mean, he should be okay to just farm out here.
Oh.
I think that they should probably be trying to block that hard camp on the side of Imperial so that Alliance isn't able to pull it and spread their levels. But if not, they can just keep pushing the wave out and making sure that Alliance can't pull that.
Oh, Noya. They know he's there. There's no mana leak. There's level 1 on EGM. In comes the fortune.
That's an ogre,
well.
Though. Like, you don't want to be hitting an ogre.
That's a very tanky ogre, and they might be able to get this kill. No, they won't. Lift is there. Actually, lift him towards EGM, but no, I can't get him around. And it is the kill that goes to EGM as well with the right click of the Caudle.
Nice play there from Alliance.
Very nice. The question is just Imperial gonna change their lanes? Because
yep, they changed it.
Yeah. He's moving top. That means SCJO will probably make a rotation down bottom after harassing Yorosanfan and perhaps making Yorosanfan a little bit sad here. Gets out of Burrow Strike away. He probably needs to.
The range on that level 1 Burrow Strike. He definitely tried clicking it a few times and it's not casting.
Yeah.
Oh god.
Gotta get out. I know there's a way.
And Void goes bottom lane now. So they just... this is fine. Just moving the lanes around. It's funny looking, but...
Hey, you do what you have to do. All for the greater good of getting that gold. Sand King has to go back to base because he can't really lane against a Drow Ranger, I think. Right?
What was that? I got distracted by Toby.
Wait a second. EGM might have been distracted by something as well as he ends up dropping here to the punches of SCJO.
Yep. So now this tri lane is pretty strong. They can't really go on the void ever. It's only if the Oracle or the...
Oh, Baby Knight.
Baby Knight.
He might get a return kill, but he's in a lot of trouble. He doesn't even get a return kill for that one. That's Hanskin rotating in.
Nice movement there.
Very nice. So how do you feel like a Drow Ranger does against Sand King? He's not... the rotation is complete, though.
And the reswap.
The reswap is here. Naga Caudle is back on top. Ace is
this is
bottom.
Actually hilarious.
Do you know how I normally...
four lane spots in 4 minutes.
It's crazy. You know how I normally write down lanes in Dream League? Who's playing, who's going where and stuff? This would be the nightmare.
Jonas in some deep trouble. He's dead.
Boom.
Four heroes.
Yeah, I mean, if you're going to teleport everybody over, you might as well wait until you get a kill before you teleport people out. As to Joe actually doesn't have a teleport. He might have to walk back to base.
No, he's going just suicide or something. I don't know. Yeah, he's got to walk back to base, but Ogre's going to make the rotation to get the XP at least from that offlane in the meantime.
Yeah. No, I got Illusion still sitting there, though. It's about to disappear, so it's fine. Well, they might have tried to make a rotation there. Nice Dire scan, knowing that Baby Knight's farming that camp. And the supports rotate to behind the Ogre Magi. This could be Noya in trouble.
At least Alliance is making, like, making moves. They're not static. They want to just be moving around a bunch. The supports are making plays. It's not like this boring game where it's a guard that stacks jungle farm, you know? At least we've got, like, the pressure. They're trying to actually do stuff. So it's fun.
Yeah.
It's much better to watch than these static farm games.
Yeah, because we said that maybe Alliance has the more difficult lineup to execute in terms of just having the patience and having to work around Imperial while Imperial wants to be the one to fight mid-game. But they're doing a pretty good job. Oh, top lane. They want to try and go for something here. Lift up. Oh yeah, you're in a lot of trouble. But Baby Knight comes in to try and maybe get some revenge here. As Loda is going to be the target for Baby Knight. The South comes out and it is enough.
Joe jumped in too.
Joe jumps in and he is going to be going back again. They don't get a return kill. Loda lives due to the clutch save of the South. And I think Baby Knight will be... Oh, I was going to say be okay. But Lim comes in.
He's out of mana.
Yeah, can he chase? There's a lot
Should
of trees around,
so
Limp is gonna get this kill.
Arcane Rune.
I think. Yep, there you go. Arcane Rune Timber is one of the worst nightmares.
Yeah, he just got a regen rune too, so he was full mana, but
Oy.
Baby Knight actually made a costly mistake there, dropping the Remnant. He ran out of mana, so I think he actually would have gotten the kill on Loda if he hadn't used that and just been jumping around.
Oh, that is Hester Joe in a lot of trouble. He doesn't have a time walk available. And he will try to make it out alive. Noya is following him.
He's good.
They both live. They're so tanky.
That was close.
They're thinking about going back in. Everybody's so low on the side of Alliance. Okay, Hanskin's teleporting out. The rest is leaving as well. Yeah.
But Loda's moving so much, he's getting a little bit underfarmed in comparison to Ace, who is leading the net worth board.
Yeah, quite a bit as well.
Baby Knight died mid. Then they tried to make a nice bait play in the top lane when he made the rotation, and then he dies again right afterwards, so he's actually getting super pressured. His net worth is very low, and not what you'd want to expect from your Storm Spirit mid lane with the Drow Aura.
Yeah, that is a little bit unfortunate. He will need some time to catch up, but he only just came back to lane. He already has to use three of his bottle charges to be even close to a decent HP again, but perhaps this rotation will help them get a kill on the Timbersaw. Timbersaw is such a difficult hero to kill, though, so... And they actually back off as well. They don't see him right now. They need to pop the salve as well. Oh! Hello! Bye, Ace. I think you're gonna be dead soon. Illuminate coming through as well. There's a lift available on Hanskin and a Timbersaw, just in case. Buy something.
Aww. Could have bought his Ogre Club or his double Band of Elven skin there. Lost 170 gold, though. Not the biggest detriment.
But he would have lost less if he bought something.
Yep, exactly.
There you go.
Or nothing. You would have lost nothing, maybe.
So four people rotating for the kill on the Drone Ranger. That's worth it, surely.
Toby's just way too loud right now, eh?
Four people rotating to kill the Drone Ranger.
Yeah. It's a little bit of an overcommitment, but he was the highest net worth hero, so it's okay.
It's okay. Drow's still on top of the net worth, though, despite that. As Limp had to rotate as well, so he farmed really well when he was in lane, and then he went top and bottom. Sure, he got kills, but apparently that gives him less gold than just sticking it and getting those creeps. As Drow Ranger kills off the Naga Siren in their push. What happened, Loda?
Void's not six, right? That wasn't a chrono.
It was a chrono!
That's what I thought. I was like, how the hell did they get Naga? But yep, the chrono makes sense, and they get a tower out of it. That's a very big kill.
Yeah, a lot of gold going the way of Ace as well.
Yep, secure tower last hit.
Uh-oh. There's three people around Hesajo. You may want to need time walk. That Sand King would have already run away if that was a problem there. Can you run away? Is there backup in time? The storm comes in, the burrow strike's still there, but the time walk should be in time. Epicenter, though, is still there, and he cannot time walk anymore. Storm cancelled his TP.
I feel like he could have actually just jumped toward the tower with the mana leak. Then they would have had to commit, like, under tower and everything, yep. So it would have been a little bit more risky for Alliance, but... Yeah, either way, they actually have to commit the epicenter, and they did, so... Alright, that's okay. It's actually not so bad for the Void, as long as they don't lose the tower down there.
And the Drow Ranger is still alive, and you say as long as they don't lose the tower, well, there are still two people hitting the tower.
Yeah. I think they actually cancelled the TP down there.
Yeah. The Storm was about to teleport in, and then he cancelled it. Thinking, okay, well, Rehesta Joe, you're dead. You're on your own. Radiant's bottom tower. It looks like the lanes have stabled up a bit. Mostly because the laning stage kind of is over. We have Ace just farming wherever he can, including the jungle right now. I think for Imperial, though, I think their storm is going to be the one that is going to hold them back a bit in terms of tempo.
Yeah, for sure. But still, it's fairly even across the board here. Jonas should go down here.
Oh,
nice little stun away.
Burrow strike, and he gets healed loads by Riot, so happy times. If only have one more Purifying Flames, that would have been a kill. He's almost full life again by the time he makes it back to base with this Strangle Boots.
Oh, and he buys a lot of small items. He was actually fairly close to the... He was at like 1600, and he gets all these... He wants to just fight. He doesn't want to go for that flank. He just wants to run at people.
Or maybe he thought he was going to die. It's like, must buy.
Yeah.
But then he could have sold it as well in time properly.
Oh, that's a Lothar rush.
That is.
Draw Ranger instead of the Dragonlance. Interesting.
Unusual. And something that maybe Alliance also is not expecting. Well, they would have seen Draw Ranger by now, but something that they'll have to play around. Just an extra little thing that Imperial can use to be more aggressive, because they need to be aggressive.
Yep. He can get behind the lines of the towers and stuff. Maybe if he can expect where the Coddle's going to be when they're pressuring towers, he can be like the ganker, but usually that's not what your Draw Ranger does. First, usually we do see, like, I know we've been seeing a lot of the Lothar, but usually it's like the Dragonlance into the Lothar. So he's changing it up a little bit.
Well, smoking. Let's see where they can go. I'm not sure if they can even kill off the Sand King. He can just burrow strike away. He also has a Rubik backing him up. There we go, Chrono helping him out. In comes the Rubik. That's a steal and a solo Chrono by Hanskin. Gets the stun on the Oracle there with the Chrono Spear. Well, at least he used it instantly.
He really wanted to try to save his buddy.
Still over 2 minute cooldown for it now, so he won't get it back again.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Well, maybe they can get a tower off the back of it. There's five people waiting to see if someone comes.
Yep, Ace is playing in the back, waiting for the Coddle to maybe try to go for a blast, but Alliance seems to be wise enough to not make that decision.
Master Joe's showing up in mid lane defending their tower as Ace comes in to take the last hit on the bottom one.
And Ryze has placed the most wards so far, so we're doing good on that one, Shiva.
Nice.
Yeah, four wards by Ryze.
Least deaths, though.
Yeah, that's gonna be,
Master Joe died a few times.
He did.
Once only, though. Just have to have Ryze feed a bit and Timbersaw feed a bit.
Oh, they actually want to try to get the denying for this fight, and I think Imperial's okay with just letting that get denied. Whatever.
Tower is a tower. Oh, hello, Sand King. Bye, Sand King. So does the Imperial want to fight right now? Is that what their play is? With the Shadowblade before Dragonlance even, surely you want to try and make something happen with that.
Yeah, at least try to pressure the towers. They're just going to wait for the next Chronosphere. I think they're just going to play around Chrono like every single time. But Lode is doing quite well for himself. Like, we actually haven't seen how much cash he's sitting on. Let's see, he's got the 1900, he went for the Bassy and the Iron Talon as well on top of the Arcane. So he's in a decent spot. Maybe he's missing maybe like 500 from the ideal that you want to be, but that's probably from TPing around so much and dying once.
Maybe missing some last hits with all the moving that he did. Medium Ace, though, he's having a fun time with all these towers. Another fortification comes up. They just got that back from denying the bottom tier 1 tower. This time, will they want to have it denied? They're going to go back in for it, and they do not want to have it denied. They get the last hit, and that means they back off, because that's all they want right now. Wow, as this Shadowblade is not really doing much just yet. But that's also because Alliance is playing very careful.
Yeah.
You see that as they smoke.
They have Alliance, or they have Houndskin with the Chrono still, so they have Chrono plus Timbersaw plus the Caudal Blast, who can also bring the Naga if they need to use the Sleep to get away after they make a play. But this is, I think this is exactly what Imperial needs to do too. They should be getting into the enemy jungle, putting wards down, keeping tabs on Loda at least, because they haven't even really looked for him too much after the first Chrono they got the kill on him.
Well, Loda is now bottom lane as well, so
yep.
Now Imperial's not going to find anybody in their rotation.
So they should ideally have an entrance jungle ward into their jungle and a deep jungle ward in the enemy jungle, just so they can spot the movements from Alliance and to spot the movement mostly from Loda.
Radiant's top tower has been denied.
Alliance is just trying to give Loda space, give Loda farm. Let their entire
Radiant's
play right now. And it's working out.
Yep.
For now, I say. ZGM gets a little bit of a stun there in the face by Noya. Some ignite. But the Naga Lucius is coming out. Should warn Imperial that there's a lot of people around here.
I heard a shot.
And they have a lot of sentries as well, so if they stick around, they would see Ace rotating as well.
Yep.
If he would go to scout, which is the question. I don't know, it must be very frustrating for Imperial right now, because they want to try and get those fights, but they just... They only want to fight when they make the rotation, and they just don't find anything.
Yeah. Alliance is doing a good job of just not fighting. Like, that's kind of what they want to do. It's a Naga lineup, you know, it's going to be a little bit slow and boring, but that's the tempo of the drafts.
Yep. That's what they prefer.
Maybe a little bit more from Imperial, but the way Alliance laned and kept swapping the lanes definitely worked out in their favor a bit.
Yeah, and even without Radiance, these Naga Illusions are already fairly annoying to deal with. Oh, Timbersaw with an Arcane Rune.
Yep, and Lim's about to be getting up his Bloodstone.
Yeah,
pretty soon.
Can they kill Hester Joe?
They need the Rubik and the Sand King.
They have the Sand King.
Do
with the Blink Dagger.
Okay, cool. And they don't have the Chrono anymore, unfortunately, but... Oh, that map hacking range creeps.
Oh, how did he know?
They always do that. It's actually unbelievable.
They just went into the...
They have the same vision, right? Like, the range creeps? But I swear to God, the range creeps are always just like, oh, I know you're in there.
Well, in that little batch, he was indeed the first one to pull aggro. So the aggro range seems a bit higher.
Yep.
Even though the range creep wasn't in the front of the queue. You're right.
So here... Alliance shouldn't even be able to get a trade here, actually. Because Ace takes out that top tower quite quickly, and... Yeah, they're getting their... A little bit of momentum for this side of Imperial, getting nice tower money up on that Storm Spirit, who definitely needs it after a couple struggles that he had.
Oh... Again, Hester Joe.
Oh yeah, I know I'm gonna keep saying it, and apologies, habit. I usually call Shadowblade Lothar, just remember that it's the same item for you guys who didn't play Dota 1, apologies.
Oh yeah. When I went into the Dota 1 lobbies, that was the question. How do you build Lothar?
Yeah.
As a proof that you knew how to play Dota.
Yeah. Oh, like we mentioned in the draft, you can just Fate's Edict and you don't even have to use False Promise.
Maybe that was the plan all along. Like, I'm gonna epicenter him so that you can steal Fate's Edict because you'll have to use it. Oh, can they get a Chronosphere out here? They don't need to. They don't need to whatsoever. That is a dead, dominating Rubik.
That's actually a pretty big mistake there from Jonas, to be honest. That's a huge waste of the epicenter. That actually could be the... No, actually, never mind. I was gonna say it could be the potential for them to try to go for a Rosh, but no. Versus Naga Siren and Timbersaw, it's way too difficult. But yeah,
but it's still it's a big mistake.
Yeah, it definitely is. Like, you should know that you're going on Oracle. You don't need to. If you're gonna go for the Epi, he doesn't even need to use his ultimate. He just uses the Fate Edict and it's completely negated. And speaking of Jonas making a few mistakes,
and they don't have the detection. Oh, but they are gonna chase him down. And they get the kill, but now, mana leak, stunned up, can he get away? He has got some bottle charges available, Houndskin is on the chase as well, he's got himself the Static Remnant instead of the actual Zip, but with the Timbersaw there, they just get chased regardless. The long range is there. There's no tier 1 tower with the TP to get him any help. Baby Knight is going to try to juke this. He's actually going to be okay. In the meantime, in the back of the fight, the supports came and killed Hanskin again. I say support. Sorry, Hester Joe, you're not a support.
But yeah, and it's nice that Hester Joe is actually farming too. Like, he's not this, you know, Vlad's or this, like, Blink Dagger and then no other items. He went for the Diffusal, so he's going to scale pretty hard. So he can remove the Mana Leak off himself. I think that's actually the only one.
If he wants to remove Caustic Finale, he can.
Yes, can.
He can.
Oh no, Limp! Oh, he's fresh bloodstone. He gets a suicide off, but
yeah. Charges left.
It defuses just a nice. It's a really nice damage item. Gives you tons of agility. It gives you the mana burn as well, which is obnoxious. But yeah, you can purge off a couple. I think you can purge off ensnare too, right? That's always one of the ones that I'm confused about. I think you can.
I want to say yes, but you may be confused there too. But I think yes, you can.
80% sure.
Why would he use his ultimate there? What's he gonna do?
Dyer's bottom tower. Just blast.
Just blast. Well, that was a tier 2 tower down again. There's one left on the side of Alliance.
So Lotus should have that Radiance online now, right? I believe I saw him pick it up.
Relic at least, and the Courier is on the way, yeah.
So 20 minutes with the Arcane Boots, Iron Talon, PMS. One or two minutes delayed because of all the moving around and the one death he had, but still, decent timing for Lotus.
Very decent. Just a question if the game is going to last long enough for him to become the Naga Siren that Alliance wants him to be. And it's a question for Imperial if they can continue with applying some more pressure. They're not really applying that much pressure. I feel like they're not really stopping Loda from farming or even lessening his farm territory at all.
Baby Knight, what the heck? You see his items? He's got the Arcane Boots and the Bloodstone. What the hell?
He wants mana. Mana leak, dude.
Why does he got Arcane Boots, though?
Because mana leak, maybe. I don't know. That's the only thing I can think of.
Yeah, I guess maybe he'll go for a... he definitely won't go for a Lotus. I don't know. Usually you see the people disassemble the Arcane Boots into the Bloodstone every time, and then you go for Treads.
Is there any chance...
But I don't know.
...he go for Aetherlens?
No. I don't think Aetherlens... The only one was... what? Was Lotus Orbs? Yeah, Lotus Orb, right? Still requires that. So, I don't know, but that'd be really bizarre. Whatever, like, he just maybe wants a little bit more mana. It's you miss out on some attack speed and stuff for, like, solo kills and everything, but it's not the biggest deal, I guess.
Yeah. Okay, 1800 gold, Chronosphere coming out, and the Sand King, where's the backup? They have the Drow Ranger there, but Drow Ranger, there's a lot of people behind. The Sleep comes out. Sand King is already dead. Illuminate, gonna hit on both. In comes the Timbersaw as well. If they kill Ace, that would be amazing. He doesn't have a gust available and he will get netted and killed. Hester Joe, no net available for him anymore, but they didn't come for him anyway. They just wanted Ace. And they got him. He barely lost any gold though. Good kill.
Yeah, definitely a good kill. Using the Lothar to get to the Sand King faster actually ended up killing him. I think he would have made it anyway with the Chronosphere. He could have just walked and busted, but I think he wanted the bonus damage, so I think that actually inevitably killed him, but they may have had detection anyway. But Baby Knight with a big jump, I think it's a nice easy pick up on the Rubick. Putting a little bit of pressure on Limp, but they shouldn't be able to kill him here. Rise! Oh, you're deep.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, my friend.
Why did he make that little thing
with you? A little, I think he was trying to double nuke EGM, but...
Well, that's yeah, he still got one off. Congratulations. But yeah, the false premise was indeed false. It was a fun. Has got the Blink available on the Epicenter as well, so he might just try something there. He goes for the Blink Dagger first, goes for the Phase's Void, who gets picked off, and Alliance. They're just getting kills all over. Now Ace shows up as well. There's already a Centaur, so the Invis doesn't really do that much. They get some damage up on Limb, but that's about it.
Yeah, a couple mistakes from Imperial there, being a little bit cocky, I'd say. But Ace does finish up his Aghanim Scepter on the Drow Ranger, so looking pretty good for him. And yeah, looking like a fairly even game.
Yep, net worth is still in favor of Imperial, but
yeah,
that's partially due to all the towers going down.
Yeah, it's even in the fact that they like they there's a Naga, you know.
Their game plans are both doing okay-ish.
Yeah.
I would say, actually, Alliance may be doing a little bit better in that regard.
Hmm.
Wouldn't Imperial want to be further ahead right now based on their lineup?
Probably a little bit further ahead, but they, as we mentioned in the draft, like, Alliance's lineup gets literally completely countered by PPVs, and that's Imperial's just building up items. They have the Bloodlust, which scales indefinitely. They have a Tricore. And once they get those BKBs online later on in the game, it's going to be really hard for Alliance to really do anything. So they're just, I feel like they can be a little bit calmer instead of making all these like risky dives in place. They can just be like, all right, guys, let's just stack Ancients. Let's let Alliance try to come to us because we've got the Oracle save anyway. If we do want to be making, like, have one guy farming in a position that's a little crazy, the Oracle can just sit behind him and there's like no way Alliance can kill him. Mm-hmm. So even they hear me and they are like, nope, we're aggressive. We have Chrono up. That's fine. With Chrono, they can make some aggressive plays. That's just
We can see where they're going, and they're not actually going to find anybody.
Yeah. Dire uses the scan near the Roshan pit, trying to see if that's what's going on. Ace.
Nobody there. There's a Rubik hiding in the trees, but that's about it. Woohoo! Nothing went cracked.
Yeah.
We're doing it. Bottom tower has fallen. Yeah, Roshan's still not dead, actually.
Yep.
Oh, Alliance is fine. They're farming. I think one of the downsides of having the Knight of Siren farm that the rest normally wouldn't get that much, but I kind of feel like that's not the case this game because they have so much map control. And now they are the ones to smoke up.
Let's see if they can get a play up. But I don't think they should. They do have vision here of Ace. Where's the Oracle? He's actually very far. Okay, they go on Noya instead. So Ace got on the high ground. They should be able to get a nice free kill on Noya here.
Well, he gets safe right
there. Speaking of that,
nice Chronosphere. Three in there. In comes Baby Knight as well with the Vortex on the Naga Siren. There is a song available. Can Loa get it up in time? Yes, he can.
Thank God, because he has the gem. If he dies there, that would have been really crappy. Baby Knight though.
On to Loda. Is there a Vortex available? 5 seconds for that one. In the meantime, Loda is still fine by the looks of it. He also found not so much though. This is where those mana boots come into play. They really want Loda, but they're not going to get him. He's too fast.
Ace is chasing.
He's too fast.
Oh my goodness. That was very scary for Alliance. Very nice Chronos here from Hesta Joe.
Very pretty one, yeah. Getting three in there, including the Naga Siren. Perhaps they shouldn't have gone for the Coddle first in the Chrono, that's the one that they killed first. Maybe go for Loda first, but...
Yeah, and like we mentioned it multiple times, Alliance's lineup is almost all magical. Sure, they have some Cure from Limp and stuff with the Swirling Death and his Chakram, but Oracle just uses Fate's Edict, his ultimate, and the Ogre, I don't think Ogre even died, right?
No, he didn't.
Yeah, so he just takes literally no damage. Everything is negated from those abilities.
He was fine. Okay. Has to Joe Rotten. Sitting on Intellect Threads.
Yep, the lads finished up. What else?
I just heard Owen compliment my camera control.
Did he?
Yeah.
Was he flaming or was he
actually
complimenting?
No, he was nice.
Very nice.
She's actually doing pretty okay.
Nice. I guess that's a compliment.
Somewhat. Like, he was probably expecting me not to do okay.
Yeah,
that's
Owen.
What it sounds like.
You hear that, Owen?
That's not nice. Okay. So, Alliance. Again, on the aggressive, or at least in terms of putting all in the enemy jungle, but that's also what Imperial is doing.
Yeah, Imperial can now pick up a gem of their own. And Baby Knight's actually on decent timing. He's maybe a little bit gold behind, but... He's got ideally as a Storm Spirit, you want that like 3 item timing by 30 minutes. So you want your Orchid, your Bloodstone, a couple charges, and like your BKB coming online quite soon.
Yeah, maybe Imperial, they're gonna go for the last tower. It feels like they're farming a lot less than what Alliance is. Am I right in saying that, you think?
Yeah, they push the waves out incredibly fast though with Storm and Drow. With Aghanim's Maelstrom, he like 3-shots the creep wave and Storm Spirit clear the creep wave instantly, but bottom wave is pushing in pretty heavily, so Alliance has a lot of information from that, as well as the wards that they have down, and Imperial doing smart things versus the gem on the Naga. They are putting high ground wards instead of putting any low ground wards, so they don't lose any of those, and now Baby Knight's got the gem.
It's always good. Well, so far, Alliance again inside that Radiant jungle. And maybe they can find someone. They're gonna try it at least. They're gonna try to go on the Drow Ranger. She does have backup and the Shadow. There's no detection. There is. Oh! Chrono's here up on three again, but Jonathan Fan doesn't in there. He gets the burst like an ace dies.
Oh, and they get loaded.
They get loaded though.
Into his death by ETM.
Oh my god.
They get ace at least, but oh no, ETM.
He actually called him with a recall inside the chronosphere.
Yeah, he pulled him in as Tested Joe jumps in and gets a.
it's like a perfect chrono.
That's the gem from Alliance taken out. They get ace, but that is not value.
Nope. I think Ace is pretty happy dying for that.
Oh my god. EGM, we need to talk.
Getting the gem as well is actually pretty huge.
Yeah, that's very big because they just bought one of their own. Now they have that one as well. Nice little pickups. Ogre gets his level 11 now, so he's doing very well. And the Jonas is only level 13 on a core sanking. His net worth is not really that great looking either. He's having a bit of a rough game.
Nyga Cyber would have had buyback, but while being dead.
Oh my god, Baby Knight. What the hell is he doing?
Dying. Losing his gem. Can we run away? No, teleporting up.
He's okay.
A-okay.
Baby Knight wants to just give me a heart attack.
Well, Loda doesn't want to get brought places anymore by EGM, so buys his own boots of travel. Solid. As, Mana Leak still hits on a creep, I think. He did cast it, yeah. Maybe he gets it off. Maybe he purged it off.
Ooh.
Yes, the Fuchsia Blade. I said it that way because someone in the chat said it that way.
The Fuchsia.
Okay, so Imperial. You're saying they're okay with being patient.
Yeah, they've got a Tricore versus a single core Naga. Tricore with Bloodlust.
But Naga Loda.
But they got a Storm Spirit. Like, Storm Spirit's super good versus the Universe Naga later on.
But Naga Loda. But Alliance. Alliance late game.
Yeah, it's. If they had another. Oh, he actually completes the. Okay, interesting. He completes the Bloodthorn instead of going for a BKB. So he feels like he's not going to die anyway, which. You know, that's a preference. It removes the evasion from the... No, Radiant's just an aura effect, so I don't think...
Oh, bye.
But, make some crit, get the instant crits, or the, you know, everybody crits, the mini crits on the target, that is.
Mm-hmm. And that is a very, very nice for the draw as well.
Yeah.
So where do you go from here on the Draw Ranger? Is it Manta Style to get those split pushes going? Manta Style, Boots of Travel?
He could do that, but maybe he wants to just... I think he can go for pretty much anything, honestly. I think Butterfly is a good option, because like you mentioned, they have no physical damage. If he gets that, like, Butterfly BKB, he's pretty set. Butterfly BKB Mjolnir, because he has the Maelstrom anyway. Probably has to get rid of something eventually, though. So he does buy the BKB on the Drow, he's no risk. I think that's the best play that he could do.
Well, Sil's gonna be the one to teleport back all the time. He doesn't actually have a teleport scroll anymore now. Or have space for it.
Oh, Jonas.
Hello!
In a position. All by himself, though.
Yeah.
Let's see if the range creep spots him this time. No, he's a little bit further down. Go, range creep, go!
Outside of the range.
Yeah.
Okay, he's teleporting out. He's going actually to the place where I should have been as well, where Storm gets a kill on the Rubick, and then everybody
jumped,
backs up.
He jumped pretty far for that one. They have some deep wards now on the side of Imperial since the gem was taken.
Oh.
They don't have vision.
Talking about diving or jumping deep, that was Hester Joe, but the song is used to stop that.
That's a fresh level 16 song too, so it's only 60 second cooldown.
Yep.
But Hester Joe now has that blink dagger, so they have long range of initiation, and now this is the go for the Roshan. There's no sleep.
First team to get Roshan Imperial! For right.
Right, yep.
Yay!
Connected.
Unless someone comes to snipe it, but I don't think that's gonna be the case. They're gonna be too late with that. Woo!
All four correct.
No, we're still having one, right?
All four correct.
Oh, there we go. Least
yeah, no,
deaths.
They're all correct.
No, at least
deaths. Oh, no, least deaths. Crap, I forgot.
Pastor Joe still
jump.
Died twice.
Jump onto Limp.
What? That's... Oh my god, that's a really long jump. It might be enough. No, it is not yet. But he keeps jumping forward, the blink away. Gets himself to the other side of the ground and TP's out. The bottle charges will make sure that he is going to be okay. That's an illusion, guys.
So now that he has the Yo Scepter as well, Hester Joe can actually purge that off too. So that's another little use that he can get from it, but overall it's a solid item.
Yeah.
Upgrading it up too, so now he's got the 7 new fresh charges.
What's this?
Are they gonna go for this? Jonas is getting in position. They could probably burst him down with a Coddle Blast on top of an Epi Stun.
Let's see it!
Is he gonna step up for another wave? Nope. Hester Joe.
Oh, Jonas and Fan needed Hester Joe to go for another wave. But Hester Joe went for it to join his team. Even Carlo is just... Come on, guys. Oh well, whatever. Enjoy your time in the trees. Face in the meantime, on the bottom lane. Bottom lane is all the way pushed out. That's gonna be one of the more annoying things to deal with. All the illusions the whole time. Because it's not just... the mirror image is also the Mantis style. Courier. Run! Run! You have the speed boost! Woo! He's fine. Didn't buy anything though, but... Oh, hello! Storm decided that he would get some revenge there for harassing the courier. He gets a kill on the Coddle, but Sand King teleported out just in case. In the meantime, in the mid lane, there is a Chronosphere. And that is a stunned up... very sad Timbersaw, and he is so sad that he killed himself.
I think he's done that every single time since he's done the Bloodstone. I don't think we've been seeing him actually gain Bloodstone charges.
He's now got 8 charges left. Hester Joe jumps in, Hanskin gets himself the time lock, already used it though, so... Oh well. Imperial, they're all sitting here, and they're all ready to fight. And I know Baby Knight is, he can't wait to jump someone else. 20 Bloodstone charges. He's doing quite well for himself. As soon as he sees Hanskin, he might try to jump in because he can.
Yeah, he recovered super well, honestly. All the towers giving him that little bit of money really helped.
Blinding Light trying to tap up. Burrow Strike actually hits up on the Storm. Here comes a song as well. Who do they want to go for? It's a Drow Ranger.
He doesn't have the BKB up.
Jonas of Fan going for the Epicenter. Where is that Oracle? Can he help save? Yes, he can! It is Drow Ranger that doesn't take any magical damage. Congratulations. In the meantime, David Knight jumped forward. He gets Burrow Strike still. Jonas of Fan has to escape there. In the meantime, the rest of the fight is happening right here. It is the Drow Ranger that still ends up going down, and the Oracle ends up dying with him. The rest of Alliance chasing down Hester Joe. Hester Joe jumping away. Doesn't have a time lock available for another 2 seconds and will not be able to use it.
Nice.
He dies.
Nice sleep there by Lota for that setup. Ace ended up taking a little bit too much damage, even though he did have the magic immunity and everything from the Oracle for a little bit. It would just prove to be just a bit too much damage, and the Storm actually didn't even blow his Aegis, so he was a little bit afraid of dying twice. But now let's see if he goes for a little bit of a nice little solo play. He might be able to get a kill off or two.
We saw him! Silent Stop!
For the Timber.
Yeah, let's see, there's no Vortex available anymore, but there's a lot of mana for Chase. Oh, or for Burrow Strike, or for Escape, that's the Aegis gone. He did not realize that he would be spinning into the Rubik. He makes a long zip.
Oh my god, yeah, he would just got the hell out of there. How much? That was probably a pretty good, efficient use of the Aegis, though, right? Because I think it was going to be getting reclaimed quite soon anyway. So that's just fine. And
that
it looks like he picks up another item, which I believe will be the Lincoln Sphere. On the Stump Spirit, that is?
It is complete. The Maelstrom is now also complete. Mjolnir, rather, complete on Ace. And I think we're going to be wrong with our last prediction, because Hester Joe died again. That fight.
Yes, he did. That's okay. 3 out of 4 is not bad.
Is it Nags? No. Wait.
EGM is... quite broke this game. He's been buying majority of the wards, but... Sire used a scan, checking out if anyone's setting up, since they did see a couple heroes of Alliance pushing there, so Alliance does the scan, but Imperial's just pushing out lanes.
This is what Imperial wants though, right? They want Alliance to try and fight them, because they want to fight.
Yep, Imperial just, they just, like we mentioned, they have a tri-core lineup. They definitely don't want to fight versus a super farmed Naga anyway, so they probably want to be ready to fight with their BKBs and their Chronosphere whenever it's up, but
yeah.
Keeping the lanes pushed out is just fine. It's just a tier 2 if they lose that top one, which at this point is whatever.
Yeah, it's all good. They take the tier 1 on Alliance. Oh, tier 2 rather. And they teleport back mid. Even though there's no creep wave on the entire lane. On both sides. Let's see if they can make something happen. They really want someone to come in range of this ward right here. Maybe Loda. That's the real one.
His Manta's on cooldown as well.
Ah, they know where he is. They chrono him from the far end. And there's the damage coming out. The Naga Siren cannot get the bomb up. Or can he? No, he cannot. Illuminate. He'll do a lot of damage there. Has to go. Gotta be backing out there. Jonas Fan doesn't have a burst strike available anymore. And his Blink is... His Blink of Force Tap was not available either. So there's two extra dead. There is one buyback available on the Naga Siren.
The Lightning procs with the Bloodlust, plus the Bladzor and everything, they're dishing out so much damage inside of that Chronosphere.
And there's the buyback. Forced out. So they gotta go again with the buyback done. Nah, they back off. The buyback is what they wanted. With the song still available as well, they don't want to have the same result as previous fights, so they back off. And they go back to farming, and hopefully for them, maybe someone comes forward. They still see that with that ward.
That's the lovely thing about playing a Void versus a single core. He's just like, all I need to do is Chrono Loda now at this point, and that's all he's going to be doing pretty much at all the stages. Of course, he wants to get more, but his real job is just getting Loda and isolating him.
At the moment, they just want to push out the other lanes first. Loda wants to do the same thing, pushing forward on the top lane. Although he got
what is Loda
back.
Picking up? Okay, so he was at 5.5k, he died, he bought back, and now he's sitting still at 4.3k, so he's...
Pretty decent.
He's just... I'm not sure what he's saving for. He's gonna go for the butterfly or, like, the heart, I guess, but... He's saving up a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
Ace is now... 6-slotted, kind of. He can still finish the Silver Edge as well.
Travels!
Alright, what am I... Silver Edge? What the hell? The hell am I saying? That's what it's called, right?
Yeah, that's what it's called.
Yeah, it's whatever. I don't know what I'm even saying.
Was it not Lothar's Edge?
Yeah.
So now it's like Silver's Edge.
I'm just confusing myself. Oh, yep. Sorry, I was talking away from the mic a bit. Yeah, sorry guys, my bad.
So good, Imperial. Still with the pressure on mid lane. They smoke up behind the wave as well. That is an illusion, and they know that. They're just waiting for someone, anyone, to come out of the base. This is a nice one. Goes for the silence straight away. First stop, he wanted to go up the high ground. He can't get that done. The Vortex is used into the yields as well. Here comes a Chrono. It's on like a Siren Loda trying to stay alive. But
he's got no buyback.
He's got nothing. EGM's got nothing either. Limp is just stunned up, trying to do whatever he can. In the meantime, everybody else is dying around him, including EGM on his Rubik, who buys back. Infinity. Now he jumps back in limp. Really wants to get that support. He's not gonna get it this time. Oh, Rubik, you're dead again. That's a dieback and that's limped out as well. No buybacks available, and that is a GG. Well played, Imperial. They're doing it and they get the win.
Loda died with 5k gold too, so he couldn't even like go buy anything. He wasn't sure what to get, but yeah, just Imperial overall, I think just stronger draft in general. They weren't under really any like big pressure in this game. It was just like them just they had bloodlust with the triple core versus a single core Naga, so I think that it was just like Imperial